Welcome back to another RTE video. Today, we will look at Supernote's 2023 software roadmap. As a company, Supernote uses a public Trello board to gather suggestions and displays a list of queued updates along with the development status of each. Each feature is categorized under 8 areas: systems, calendar, recognition, and keyboard, paint and screen mirroring, handwriting, notes, documents, widgets, and user interface. Let's look at what's currently in progress, meaning the features are set to be released in an upcoming beta or already in beta testing. The first is third-party cloud services. Next is handwriting on the calendar, followed by screen mirroring, paint, links, multiple page templates, directly sharing files from the built-in email client, moving and copying pages between notes, and highlighting text in PDFs. To learn more about the progress, you can flip the card to see the developers' comments, along with comments from the community. You also have the ability to vote on which features you care about the most. This helps Supernote prioritize which features it should look at implementing next in the roadmap. Now, let's take a closer look at each in-progress card. For adding new third-party cloud services, Google Drive support is already in beta testing as of January 13. For me, I'm looking forward to OneDrive support, as that would be the primary way I would use syncing. Next is handwriting calendar. The built-in calendar isn't a feature I currently use on the Supernote, but for those that do, this will integrate a handwriting calendar with the existing calendar that's compatible with Google and Outlook calendars. Another highly anticipated feature that is already in beta testing is screen mirroring. This feature will support wireless screen mirroring from a web browser. I've been testing it, and so far, it's pretty solid. There is only a slight delay when writing, but so far so good. When it comes to painting, Supernote is looking to expand the functionality by implementing an infinite canvas, additional brushes, layers, selection tools, frames, symmetry tools, and import tools. As of last year, the ability to create links was introduced, which allowed you to create external and internal links in notes. The next phase looks to do the same in PDFs. Currently, a really nice feature is the ability to create your own custom templates. The one downside was it was restricted to a one-page PNG file. Now, in an upcoming update, you'll have the ability to create a multiple-page PDF template. For me, I'm looking forward to this update. When it comes to email, there's a built-in app that allows you to access email from a Microsoft Exchange server, Outlook, or other IMAP account. Currently, to share files by email, you have to open the email app first on the Supernote. The goal is to make the process simpler by allowing you to share by email from the file directly. Next is another feature I'm looking forward to: the ability to move and copy pages between different notebooks. Currently, the functionality is limited to moving and copying pages in the same note. And now the final in-progress feature is highlighting text in PDF documents. Now you might be thinking, doesn't this already exist? It does, however, this would be a true highlight, allowing you to make edits to highlighted text if needed on your computer. As you can see, there are dozens of features being researched and put through development. If there's anything missing, and you want it added to the roadmap, enter your idea under the suggestions column. Well, that wraps up the video. Please share in the comments which features you're excited about or would like to see added to the roadmap. As always, don't forget to click like and subscribe. This has been RTE. See you in the next video.